Good evening. Welcome to night two of the Holy Trinity Spring Band Concert. Tonight we get to hear from the Wind Ensemble and the Jazz Band. Last night was fabulous. I told Mr. Howler, oh, he got a lot of heavy lifting to do tonight. They were really good last night. But the bands have been just remarkable this year. A big thank you to Mr. Howler, Mr. Murphy. Last night I acknowledged Mr. Nixon and Ms. Hill over at the primary school for all the love and attention they put into the music program. And tonight we get to experience the benefits once again. So please join me in welcoming the director for this evening, Mr. Brian Howler. Brian.
Hello, welcome everybody. Family, faculty, staff, alumni, friends. Before I start, I want to make a special welcome to Mr. Tony Canto, who some of you may know as the former director of bands and fine arts director of Bishop McNamara High School, and he decided to spread his wings a little bit last year, and he took a position as the executive director of MMEA, which is the Maryland Music Educators Association. And that is the professional association for music educators in Maryland. So MMEA's main goal is to be an advocate for music education for every student in every school in the state of Maryland. So we're so blessed to have him as an ally and as a friend of 20-something years, Mr. Canto. Welcome to our concert tonight. So it's really good to see everybody here in the same space to celebrate the musical achievements of our students. All the music that you're gonna hear today was rehearsed before the school day even starts. So I wanna take a second to thank all the parents first for rising so early on those morning band days to get your student band rehearsals on time. And I want to say, you know, your situation is not unique because me and my wife have to do the, we have to go into the bedroom 5 times, get him crawling out of bed very slowly on those early mornings because he's on dad's a teacher schedule. So we empathize with you. But without your dedication to your students and our music program, none of this would be possible. Most importantly, I want to recognize the hard work of our young musicians. Making meaningful music in the earliest hours of the day with middle schoolers is kind of like going to the dentist. Most people don't like to do it, but after you're done, you're glad you did it. I apologize to my my dentist parents in the audience. So I constantly remind the students that it's all about the journey. And as this journey comes to an end tonight, I hope the memories made during this concert season were joyful and long-lasting. So I'm going to talk for a minute about the Wind Ensemble, which is the group that's here on stage, and the fact that we just went to Music in the Parks for the first time. So for those that don't know, we used to go to something called the Dixie Classic, and that happened in Richmond, Virginia. It was kind of the same format, but Dixie Classic did not survive the pandemic, so we decided to try Music in the Parks. And for those that don't know, Music in the Parks is a festival where you take your concert band, you play for a group of adjudicators, and you're given a rating based on your performance. And the ratings are generally poor, fair, good, excellent, and superior. And you're also, in addition, you're placed amongst in competition with other bands that are in your category, your class. And the classes are based on the size of your school. So it's 750 students or less, or 750 or more. We're 750 or less. And as I told the students, I am happy with whatever rating and placement we receive, as long as that when they left the stage, they were happy with their performance. And I could tell when they left the stage, they were very happy with their performance. So with that being said, I'm happy to report that of the 7 middle school bands in our class, we were the only band to receive a superior rating. And we left with the first place trophy out of all the 7 other bands. So I hope our performance tonight will reflect that same level of excellence for you. I'm gonna turn this over to Mr. Murphy real quick because he has an announcement about our community in general. So, Mr. Murphy.
Good evening. I have some exciting news to announce for our community. Our program here at Holy Trinity is rare. Having 100% of the student body participate in the instrumental program as a core curricular subject is unheard of in the education community. Colleagues across the country are always amazed by what we can achieve and cannot believe the unwavering support we have from our administrators, faculty, parents, and community around us. I'm excited to announce that we, as a community, have been recognized for our success on the national stage. I am proud to announce that the Holy Trinity has been honored with the Support Music Merit Award from the National Association of Music Merchants Foundation for its outstanding commitment to music education. Holy Trinity is one of 78 schools in the country to be honored with this award. The Support Music Merit Award recognizes individual schools that demonstrate outstanding achievement in efforts to provide music access and education to all students. To qualify for the Support Merit Music Award, Holy Trinity answered detailed questions about funding, graduation requirements, music class participation, instruction time, facilities, support for the music program, and community music making programs around us. This information is then reviewed by the Music Research Institute at the University of Kansas. Mr. Mullen, I am proud to present the 2023 Support Music Merit Award to you as representative of all of us. Without the support of you, faculty, staff, parents, students, and the community, myself and Mr. Holler would not be able to do this amazing work. This award recognizes the school as a whole, and that behind every note we play, there is non-musical work that happened to make it possible. Thank you so very much, everybody. This is your award, too. Mr. Mullen. Thank you so much, everybody. Congratulations.
Okay, so let's start the show. I'm going to introduce Willow Snoddy, who's going to introduce you our first piece.
Our first piece is called España Cani. España Cani is a well-known paso doble by Pascual Marquina Naro. The paso doble, which means double step, is a type of Spanish march that's performed at bullfights, usually when the participants enter the bull ring. Enter the ring with us as we take you on an adventure right into the middle of the action. Please enjoy España Cani.
Thank you. I'm Camille Days, and our second piece is called Fragile by Randall Standridge. In our media-soaked society, it is fashionable to only focus on positive outcomes. People love to hear a story of someone who beat the odds, overcomes the challenges of living with mental health issues, and comes out stronger on the other side. That is a beautiful story, but it's not everyone's story. Fragile portrays individuals who were able to get the help and support they needed and were able to flourish. Not everyone is always so fortunate. Some may say that students are too young to discuss such issues, but no, for some of them, this is their daily life. We hope that as you listen, you can hear the beauty as well as the dissonance that represents hope and struggle. Thank you.
Our final piece is called Byzantine Dances by Carol Britton Chambers. Byzantine Dances is generally meant to portray a set of Turkish dances. The opening dance is fast and energetic, written in a style of Romus Gypsy dance. The slower section in the middle of the piece is written in the style of a Zabek dance. This type of dance is often performed by a solo dancer symbolizing courage and heroism. The use of the harmonic major scale, Turkish finger cymbals, syncopated rhythms, and grace notes give this piece a somewhat exotic sound. We hope you had a wonderful time at our concert. Please enjoy Byzantine Dances.
Main complaint for the judges is that you guys weren't accenting notes enough, right? So let's go, right?
All right, we're gonna have a quick shift change here for jazz band. So some students are gonna say, some students are gonna come off, and then we'll start the jazz band portion of the program. So just sit tight for 5 minutes or so, and then we'll get changed around.
Hello, everyone. I know as you're probably getting back from your seats, from the bathroom and such, I know you're still in a little bit of discourse, but I figured I'd start out introducing our first song for jazz band, which is Avenue Swing. Our first piece is called Avenue Swing. Avenue Swing was written in the style of some of the great string era band leaders, such as Count Basie, Benny Goodman, and Glenn Miller. This piece features a trumpet solo by Daniel Haller. Shortly after the solo, we finish with a unison shout chorus that takes us to the final bars of the piece. Please swing along with us to Avenue Swing.
Our second piece is called Gospel. This gospel-style medium tempo swing chart starts off with the a cappella section for the winds, then brings in the rhythm section on the second chorus to boost the energy. Gospel features solos by alto saxophonist Eden Miller and Sierra Passy, as well as trumpeters Xavier Valentine and Alexis Graham. After the solo, an uplifting key changes right it home, brings it home. We hope you enjoy Gospel.
Our final piece of the evening is called Uptown Funk. Uptown Funk was recorded by British record producer Mark Ronson and American singer Bruno Mars. The songs draw heavy inspiration from the Minneapolis sounds of the 1980s era funk music. Upon its release, the single received generally positive reviews from critics who praised the instrumental style and influences of the track. In 2014, Uptown Funk spent 14 weeks at number one on the Billboard Hot 100 in the U.S. The songs even won 2 Grammys, including the record of this year. Please enjoy our last piece, Uptown Funk.
What do you think? Pretty good, huh? You know, one of the things that Mr. Holler didn't mention in that competition, which they were amazing, is they mentioned schools under 700. That's middle schools under 750. We're a middle school of less than 225, so even more. Congratulations, guys, to all of you. All of you, outstanding. The Holy Trinity, you know, talks about the best Jew, and one of the best Jews about the best Jew is one of the, really probably the best music program around. I think you would all agree. And Brian? Thank you very much for everything. And thank all of you for your support. We couldn't do any of it. They couldn't do it all if it wasn't for you. So thank all of you. Brian, any last words? Get home safe. Thank you again. Thank all the teachers. Thank you all. Couldn't do it without you. Now, Mr. Wood, you are the de facto Mr. Esposito, so I have to ask you, and you and Miss Server, Miss Server, come here. Yes, you.
Miss Server.
You know, there's a tradition about whether or not these guys are any good. There's a little something-something the next day. So the question becomes, Mr. Wood, Miss Server, what do you think about tomorrow?
First of all, is everybody on the good GroupMe page for me? Just kidding. Come on. All right, if you're on our GroupMe page threads, it is a free dress for all HSP students tomorrow. Thank you. Great job, guys.
Thank you.
Rest now. Have a good night.